It was high time for Corsair to enrich its SF line with stronger NATX version 3.1 compliant members. The long wait was because Corsair wanted to ensure that the new SFX units would continue the legacy of the previous models, which were among the best in this market segment. This is the case since the SF850 has achieved first place in overall performance among the few SFX and NATX version 3.1 compatible units with 850 watt maximum power. As for the SF750 and SF1000, I don't want to provide any spoilers since I will provide all the details about them in the upcoming reviews, in the upcoming videos. The reviews are already there on hwbusters.com. To increase efficiency, make the platform more reliable and save money, Corsair decided to ditch the -12V rail in these PSUs. This was a wise move since no PC part requires this rail anymore, which is a remnant of the past, and every PSU manufacturer should get rid of it ASAP. From the start of my PSU career, which was a long time ago, I didn't bother with this rail and mentioned far too many times that it should be abandoned, but only recently have the PSU manufacturers realized that. The PC industry doesn't easily accept changes that have to do with power delivery, and another fine example of this is the ATX 12V only standard, which hasn't managed so far to vanish the minor rails. My review sample arrived in a plain carton box, but since I visited Great Wall's production line in 2023, I had the chance to take a photo of the box, which I can share now. As you can see, there is no 80 plus badge, but only cybernetics. Corsair decided to drop the 80 plus certification scheme because it is outdated and super expensive and proceed with cybernetics. They can invest the money they will save from this move on R&D and produce even better products. Just saying. The dimensions are super compact since this is an SFX unit, and it is good to see a punched fan grille with large perforations, which boost airflow. The more restricted the fan grille is, the harder it is for the fan to get air, so it has to spin at higher speeds and produce increased noise. On the modular panel, instead of a native 12V 2x6 socket, Corsair uses two 8-pin microfit sockets, which are more tolerant of abuse. Don't expect to find long cables in an SFX unit since they are destined for chassis with restricted internal space. Some could argue here then why the SFX to ATX adapter is included in the product's bundled accessories. It is most likely included for users wanting to buy Corsair's Type 5 standard cables to install this PSU into a regular ATX chassis. You should expect slightly lower efficiency and increased voltage drops with longer cables because of the increased resistance, especially at high loads. This is why many manufacturers send units for efficiency certification at 80+ with super short cables. This cannot be the case in cybernetics because it provides in every report the detailed cable description table. Great Wall is the OEM of all SF and SF-L units. It is a Chinese government-owned company, so it has plenty of resources. The PCB is small and densely populated with components to deliver 850 watt of maximum power. The primary heatsink, hosting among other things the bridge rectifiers, is pretty large, while the heatsink on the secondary side is small since the FETs that regulate the 12V rail are installed on the PCB's bottom side. Overall, the build quality is high, with expensive parts and nearly impeccable soldering quality. Great Wall has state-of-the-art production lines, so I didn't expect anything less in soldering quality. I had the chance to visit all of Great Wall's factories and production lines in 2023, and the production of the new SF line took place at the time of my visit. The design is found in every modern PSU nowadays. A half bridge topology on the primary side after the PFC converter's stage, while an LLC resonant converter boosts efficiency through an almost lossless switching. A synchronous rectification scheme, including 6 Infineon FETs on the secondary side, regulate the 12V rail. The minor rails are generated from a pair of DC-DC converters utilizing an Unpack PWM controller. Rubicon provides the few electrolytic caps on the secondary side, while the many polymer caps handle ripple filtering. The fan controller is a microchip digital controller, making the fan speed profile programming easy. The cooling fan uses a fluid dynamic bearing and has a diameter of 92 mm, and the standby circuit uses Infineon parts. Great Wall gathered vast experience over the years by cooperating with Corsair to produce SFX units, and this is why it is now the number one force in this market segment. Protection features: the 12-volt rails over current protection triggering points are conservatively set, and the same goes for the overpower protections triggering points. The only issue here is that the triggering points are higher under hot conditions than cold temperatures, while normally it should be the other way around. Moreover, the OCP triggering points are set sky high on the minor rails. There is no need for such a high amperage, especially at 3.3 volt. To make matters worse, the OCP triggering points on the minor rails at cold and hot conditions are pretty close. Performance: load regulation is tight on all rails. Ripple suppression is decent. The transient response is excellent at 12 volt, where it matters the most, and it is also pretty good on the other rails. The PSU passes all ATX version 3.1 transient response tests. The 12 volt rail keeps its voltage level at a very high level in the 200% load test. Efficiency is high at all load levels. The platform's average efficiency is high. The EPFC converter needs tuning for higher PF readings at 230 volt. The 5SB rail is highly efficient. Vampire power is low enough. The average noise output is below 30 decibels at 150 volt and below 28 decibels at 230 volt, where efficiency is higher. Given the small form factor and the increased power density, the noise output results are okay. The fan's noise remains low as you don't stress the minor rails, even if the load at 12 volt reaches 400 watt. If Corsair had kept the maximum combined power on the minor rails at 100 watt, the unit's average noise output would have been notably lower. The 30 decibels mark is passed at around 565 watt at 12 volt, while with more than 630 watt at the same rail, the fan's noise exceeds 35 decibels. As you will notice in the corresponding graph, the fan's passive operation doesn't last long. On the contrary, it only lasts for a short period because during this test, I gradually apply full load on the minor rails, steadily increasing the load at 12 volt during every minor rail load circle. The specific load pattern is the worst possible scenario for this platform, but from the moment its official power specs mentioned on 130 watt maximum combined load on the minor rails, I have to follow them. Although the fan spins between 400 and 600 RPM at a light and moderate 12 volt load, and with a combined load on the minor rails remaining below 85 watt, its output noise is still low, below 6 decibels. The overall performance is top notch, and the performance of the Aris Game PSU is a pleasant surprise. Still, I don't trust this brand at this game. The new Corsair SF units are here, achieving top performance and low noise output at light and moderate loads. They could do better in noise output if their official specs restricted the maximum combined load on the minor rails at 100 watt, but Corsair wanted strong 5-volt and 3.3 volt rails. I can understand the reason for the strong 5-volt rail, ARGB, but there is no point in making the 3.3 volt rail so strong. The OCP triggering points on these two rails are high, allowing for well over 30 amps on each rail. Great Wall should fix OCP on the minor rails and bring it down to more sensible levels. The SF850's overall performance easily gives it first place in the 850 watt ATX version 3.1 SFX PSU category. However, there aren't many 850 SFX PSUs following Intel's newest standard, as it is not easy to make such a strong SFX platform able to offer twice its maximum power for short periods. I didn't have any price information on the new Corsair SF units at the time of the review of the video, but I hope their prices will stay reasonable. The extended warranty, high build quality, and the included SFX to ATX adapter bracket are the essential ingredients for a salty price. With the new SF series, Corsair marks its independence from the so far powerful 80 Plus, which insists on increasing its fees while using a vastly outdated and easy to cheat methodology. According to Corsair's PSUPM, only the Cybernetics ratings will be utilized from now on. These ratings use the average efficiency and noise readings from at least 1,450 different load combinations, from minimal to full load, and other data to tax the PSUs to the corresponding efficiency and noise categories. Before investing in a new power supply, I did my best ATX version 3.1 PSUs article on hwbusters.com to check all alternative PSU offerings. You will also find this product's review on the same site.